Hardy. Hey Hardy. Hey Hardy. Hey Hardy. Hey Hardy. Hey Hardy.
Laertes! Now you've got to acknowledge my innocence and believe that I'm your friend, since the man who tried to kill your father was trying to kill me.
It looks that way, but tell me why he wouldn't take immediate action against criminal acts like that, when everything calls for it.
Oh, for two main reasons, which may seem weak to you, but strong to me. The queen, his mother, is devoted to him. She is such a part of my life and soul that I can't live without her any more than a planet can leave its orbit. The other reason why I couldn't prosecute and arrest Hamlet is because the public loves him. In their affection, they overlook all his faults. So whatever I say against him would end up hurting me, not him.
I lost my dad. My sister was driven insane. She was the most perfect girl that ever lived. But I'll get my revenge.
Don't you worry about that. Don't think that I can be threatened and think that it's just a game, all right? You'll know my plan soon enough. I loved your father. I love myself. And that should be enough.
Who is it?
Huh. It's a voicemail from Hamlet.
Well, what did he say?
High and mighty one, you know I've been set down naked in your kingdom. Tomorrow, I'll beg permission to look into your kingly eyes, at which point I'll apologize and tell you the story of how I'm coming back to Denmark so strangely and suddenly.
What does this mean? Has everyone come back? Is it all BS and nobody's come back?
I have no clue, man. But I'd love to think about the chance to look him in the eye and say, you did this.
That's how you feel, and why shouldn't you? At least let me guide you.
Yeah, as long as you don't lead me towards peace.
No, just towards your own peace of mind. If he comes back to Denmark and doesn't plan to continue his trip, and we'll trick him into his own death. No one will be blamed. His mother will even think it's an accident.
I'll let you make the decision, as long as I'm in your plans. The agent of his death.
That's fine, but you need to be careful. Since you left, Hamlet has heard some rumors that maybe a certain quality of yours shines through better than others.
Yeah? What quality is that?
Right. 2 months ago, I met a gentleman from Normandy. I've fought against the French before. I know how well they shoot. But this man was a magician with a rifle. So good, so skillful, that even having seen him shoot, I cannot believe his accuracy.
Was it Lamond?
So you know him.
Oh, I know him. He's everyone's favorite.
He mentioned you, saying that you were an expert marksman. The best, actually. Now, when Hamlet heard Lamond mention your name, that's all he could talk about. Now, the point of that story is...
What is the point?
Laertes, let me ask you this. Did you even love your father? Or is your grief just an illusion? A mere painting of sorrow?
How could you even ask that?
Not that I suspect you didn't. The fire of love always burns itself out. Nothing stays the way it began. Hamlet's coming back. What are you gonna do to prove that you're your father's son?
I'd cut his fucking throat in church.
It's true. No place, not even a church, should offer refuge to that murderer. But Laertes, be smart about this. Lay low. He'll know you're here. We're gonna place bets on a duel. Hamlet is so careless, so egotistical, that he won't even care you pick your weapon first. You can avenge the death of your father.
I'll do it. I'll put blanks in his gun if I have to. I am going to kill him.
We'll need a backup plan in case you can't pull it off. If he escapes, I'll kill him myself.
Wait, someone's coming.
The bad news just keeps on coming. One disaster after another. Your sister is drowned, Laertes.
Drowned? Where?
There's a willow that leans over the brook, dangling its white leaves over the glassy water. Ophelia made wild wreaths out of those leaves, breeding in cornflowers, thistles, daisies, and the orchises that vulgar shepherds have an obscene name for, but which pure-minded girls call dead man's fingers. Climbing into the tree to hang the wreath of weeds on her branches, she and her flowers fell into the gurgling brook. Her clothes spread out wide in the water, buoyed her up for a while, and she sang bits of old hymns, acting like someone who doesn't realize the danger she's in, or like someone completely accustomed to danger. It was only a matter of time before her clothes, heavy with the water they absorbed, pulled the poor thing out of her song, down into the mud at the bottom of the brook.
So, she drowned.
Drowned? Drowned.
You've had too much water already, poor Ophelia. So I won't shed watery tears for you. But crying is what humans do. We do what's in our nature, even if we're ashamed of it. After I stop crying, I'll be through acting like a woman. Goodbye. I have some fiery words I could say right now, but my watery tears are drowning them out.
We need to follow him, Gertrude. I worked really hard to calm him down. I'm worried he's getting all excited again. So we definitely need to follow him. All right.